I wanted to make sure that I explained one of the posts that we put up yesterday. So Tempest and I went to Glen Allen, Virginia yesterday in order to advocate for a bill that I had carried during the General Assembly session that did not pass, but was still very important to us. And so yesterday, the Board of Housing and Community Development was meeting, and they had two committee meetings prior to the full board meeting. And during the second committee meeting, we were able to tell the story of Aqua Vista residents who, on their lease, it says the landlord will provide air conditioning. However, they did not have air conditioning. And through working with them and trying to work on changes coming to the apartment complex, that's when we learned that there is a code, a regulatory code, that says that if someone offers cooling or air conditioning, they only have to cool the room to 80 degrees. And I was in those rooms where it was 80 degrees, and it was unbearable. There were elderly people, there were people who were sick on oxygen, that had some really serious health concerns. There were children, and everybody was just hot, and it was just like oppressive heat. And it was actually cooler outside in the courtyard area than in some of the units. And so when the landlord and the property manager started to fix the problem, they were cooling the rooms to 80 degrees. And so I was wondering, like, that's still so hot, like, what's going on? Well, yes, so 80 degrees was the minimum temperature that they had to cool the room to, and I knew that that was absolutely unacceptable. So we put in a bill, House Bill 2000, from this past session, and tried to get that passed to say, if you say you offer cooling and air conditioning, then it's got to at least go down to 77 degrees. And may not sound like a lot, but it is a big difference. And so we learned when I put up the bill that typically legislation deals with the Virginia Code. And when you have regulations, those go through the regulatory process, and that's the executive branch. And so the stakeholders, from the apartment folks and the home builders and realtors, we all got together, put our heads together. Director of the Board of Housing and Community Development, Eric Johnston, we all got together, and we arrived at the fact that we could work on emergency regulations, and that would take going before the board and trying to get it passed by the board. And so that's how we all got to yesterday. So the board, the committee, the first meeting, the committee passed the emergency regulation unanimously, and then in the larger board, they passed the emergency regulation unanimously. And so now that emergency regulation goes to the Office of the Governor and the Office of the Attorney General, and also to the budget folks. And it could actually be in place by May 1st. And that the season that is used for air conditioning cooling regulations is May 1st through October 1st. And so to think that we may have at least a temporary solution in place by May 1st is just beyond what I could have asked for, knowing that the bill probably didn't have the votes to pass because of process, not content. And so I'm ecstatic. But it is a temporary relief. So as soon as the temporary regulation goes into effect, that will start the process for where the full vetting of the regulation will go through the regular process to see if we can get it as a permanent change into the regulations, to get that 80 degrees change to 77 degrees, so that we can at least make some change to what I think is an unacceptable and ridiculous minimum temperature of 80 degrees. And so it has been an amazing learning experience, myself and Tempest, and we've just been so thankful for people who are willing to work with us, knowing that the residents of Aqua Vista are not the only ones that are going through this. We heard stories in Richmond and Northern Virginia as well. And so typically, the folks that are caught in this kind of situation are in low-income housing, and it's not fair that they would have to be under 80 degrees while the air conditioning is on. And so we are trying to get fairness for them. Just like if I had, you know, an issue at my apartment, that would not last for long. And so the same kind of treatment that I would get, I want for all of the residents that live in rented apartments and where there's an expressed availability of air conditioning and cooling. And so it was a great day yesterday. We will keep you posted on hearing back from the Office of the Governor, the Attorney General, and the budget folks, and to see when this regulation can actually go in place. All of my love and appreciation and continued support to the residents of Aqua Vista who had had enough and wanted to fight for what they knew they deserved and what they believed was to be right, and will continue to work on righting the wrongs that are still going on. This situation has not been completely resolved. And so so we stand with them, we continue to support them, and we thank them for their inspiration for speaking up and fighting for what they know is right. And so we'll keep updating you, but yesterday that was pretty big. So I'll talk to you soon. Bye.